hi everyone, this is Shreeja. Welcome to Skin or Real, where I talk all things skincare. So if you like skincare related content, then make sure that you're subscribed. Likewise, you can also follow me on Instagram, where I post more regularly. So a lot of you guys have been asking me about summer skincare routines. Now I have made this very clear many times before, but I'm going to clarify once again. I can't build skincare routines for you guys via YouTube videos or even through Instagram posts or DMs. If you need me to book a personalized skincare routine for you, you would need to book a consultation with me, because before building an entire routine, a proper skincare analysis is a must. So always keep these videos that I share with you all, or even product recommendations, as a guideline. Don't just straight away take things from my video and start copying it, because it can really be damaging for your skin. I have oily acne prone skin, so I really try products that are better suited for acne prone, oily and dehydrated skin. Yes, I do try some heavier moisturizers that can be used by dry skin, but more or less most of the products that I recommend via my YouTube videos are suitable for oily acne prone skin type. So keep that in mind when you are picking up product recommendations from my videos. Now, a common question that you guys ask me is that while switching from your winter skincare routine to a summer skincare routine, should you be throwing away all your skincare products? And my answer is no. It would be such a wastage of the product, the money. And I mean, you know, we all work hard for our money. Why would you want to throw away products? And please, if you're thinking that you're going to save that cream and then start again using it again during winter months, please look at the expiry date of that particular product, because most of the creams start to expire in 12 months to like 18 months. And so is it true for actives. For actives, even the duration is less. Duration might be 6 to 9 months. So keep that in mind. You can't save your products like that once you have opened them. So how do you make that switch? Starting with my tip number one, and that is switching your cleansers. Now, if you have dry and sensitive skin and you have been using cream cleansers or milk paste cleansers, it is completely fine for you to continue using the same, because it will work for you. But if you have oily acne prone skin, then I highly recommend that you start switching to a gel based cleanser, or cleansers that have exfoliating acids like salicylic acid, because during summer months the oil production of your skin will increase. Switching to a gel based cleanser or even a cleanser with exfoliating acid can help. Another thing to keep in mind before making the switch is that when I'm saying gel cleansers, I don't mean cleansers that are going to give you that stripping harsh effect. No, always stick to a low pH cleanser no matter what kind of cleanser you are using. And also, if you have been using cleansing balms or oils for your first cleanse, shifting to a micellar water can actually help during summers. Now moving on to my next tip, and that is your moisturizers. I personally have oily skin, and even in winters I prefer to use a lightweight moisturizer during my daytime. But of course at night I prefer a heavier moisturizer, and that's how I like to keep it even in summers. Like because during the daytime I'm layering my moisturizer with a sunscreen, so the moisturizer that goes below my sunscreen has to be extremely lightweight. And at night I'm using retinoid once or twice a week, so that point of time I don't mind using a moisturizer that is slightly thick. But some of you might actually not enjoy that, and if especially if you're not using any anti-acne actives into your skincare routine, then you might consider switching to a gel based moisturizer altogether. So what to do with the moisturizer that you already have? If you have someone in your family like your mom, someone who has more mature skin type, you can give that moisturizer to them, because that will work for that particular skin type. Or if you are just living alone and you have no one to pass on that moisturizer to, then I do recommend tapering it down. Maybe use the gel based moisturizer for 5 days a week, but at night when your skin needs that extra little moisture, use that heavy moisturizer. I however don't recommend throwing it down. If it is something moisturizer which is not too expensive, you might also consider using it on your neck. So think of it, because see, I know saving money and product is our goal, but you don't want to risk the chances of pore clogging. So think of it. But honestly, I have tried all these different methods for me using a light moisturizer even in winters and summers during the day, and a heavier one at night works the best. That way I don't have to keep switching my moisturizer. Of course, if a product is over, like for instance, I'm using Rovectin Lotus Moisturizer during the day currently, and if I was using the same moisturizer at night, then I would have switched in winters, but then I was using CeraVe and that worked really well for me. But yes, for summers I am looking for an alternative. If you have any suggestions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Keep in mind, I have oily acne prone skin types. I don't prefer heavy oils in my moisturizer. Something that has cream base, that's slightly thick but is not too heavy. So that's what I'm looking for, and all your recommendations are welcome, and that way I would also be able to test and try more products for you guys. So yes, if you have any recommendations, drop them down in the comments below. So moving on to the third tip from my side, and that is, I personally love using a clay mask or a light overnight sleeping mask during summers. Currently, I have been trying this superfood mask by the Earth Rhythm. It was one of their new launches. I have only used it 4 times. So far, it's really good. It doesn't dry out my skin. I hate it when, you know, those clay mask make my skin tight and stretchy, but with this it doesn't happen. And also guys, can we take a moment and appreciate the cute packaging? Like, I love how Earth Rhythm has revamped its entire packaging, and all of this is like so colorful and pretty. So this is one mask that I have been enjoying. I'm not sure if it will work for dry skin, but for oily skin it will work really well. And this is another mask from Rovectin that I love using during my nighttime skincare routine. I use it twice a week. Of course, it's slightly on the more expensive side, but a little goes a long way, and I highly, highly recommend this if you're on your retinoid journey or if you are using too many anti-acne products into your skincare routine. I'm not someone who would mask every day. I only mask once a week. These sleeping masks work really well for me. So yes, if you're looking for a good sleeping mask for oily acne prone skin, Rovectin Cica mask would be a great choice. It is expensive and I understand, and not everyone would want to try it. So for those people, you would want to give Cosrx rice mask a try. All the products will be linked in my description below, so you would know where to go to purchase these particular products. Now moving on to my next tip, and that is switching your sunscreen. Now this one really matters a lot. During winters, I prefer sunscreens that are slightly moisturizing, but during summers I want sunscreen that gives me a matte effect. So I prefer, like, Dr. Oracle Sunblock is one of my personal favorite sunscreens that I have used for oily acne prone skin. Then I honestly enjoy Biore Aqua Sun Essence as well, but some people with oily skin feel that it leaves their skin too shiny, but I have never experienced that issue. So again, it's a personal choice. If you have extremely oily skin, then using a silicone based sunscreen will really help control the oil production, and we have a lot of options for silicone based sunscreen in India. So all my recommendations will be in the description below, because I wanted to focus on the tips and not on product recommendation in this video. But make sure you check them out so you know where to go from here if you're looking for certain products to incorporate into your summer skincare routine. Another thing is that in summers, reapplication of sunscreen can be a task. So I do recommend using a beauty blender for your second application. But of course, you need to keep in mind the quantity of your sunscreen, because a lot of it will get absorbed by your blender. So of course, if you're using half teaspoon, you might have to take a little more than that. But by using a beauty blender, you will be able to use your sunscreen properly without smudging the makeup if you are someone who wears makeup on a regular basis. I personally don't have that issue because I don't wear makeup. So for me, just using my fingers is enough. But yes, reapplication during summers can become tricky, so using a beauty blender can help. Moving on to the last tip of this video, and that is switching your essence to a hydrating toner. Essentially, these are one and the same thing, but I'll tell you what, I personally enjoy snail mucin more during winters, because I have seen if I use it during summers, it does make my skin a bit more oily. So I stick to using a hydrating water or a toner during summer months. Something with bamboo water, green tea, aloe vera, all of it works. Just make sure that the toner that you are getting has a lot of humectants instead of, you know, occlusive and heavy ingredients, For me, milk toner is a big no-no. I have tried Laneige Cream Skin. I have tried I'm From Rice Toner. Both of them gave me clogged pores. I personally stay away from those. So, and if you have oily, acne-prone skin, you might want to steer clear from these products. I'm not saying it's not going to work for you, but be careful, because I have not had a pleasant experience from milky toners. So I generally don't prefer that. I go for like light water hydrating toners during summers. Having said that, toners or essences are something which are not an essential in your skincare routine. So skip them if you like. Really, you don't need these many skincare products, but I personally like using them. So that's why I'm sharing my experience with you all. So that is all I have for you guys today. If you enjoy watching my video and you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please consider doing so, as it will really help me grow and it will hardly take 1 second of your time. And that is it. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you next time. Bye.